Thank you. Buenas tardes, hermanos. Good afternoon, everyone. And let us begin this wonderful celebration. Vamos a iniciar esta celebración con la alegría que nos une en Cristo. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. El Señor esté con ustedes.
Y con tu espíritu.
Welcome to the Class of 2021 Graduation Prayer Service. As we celebrate the 8th graders transitioning into high school, let's pray together that they will continue to be great examples of Jesus. Let it graduate, remember to let Christ shine in your lives and lead others to Jesus. May the graduates remember that Jesus said in Matthew 28:18-19, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you. And behold, I am always to the end of the age." As we celebrate today, let us remember to use our many gifts and talents to always do God's work, and to remember all things are possible with God. Thank you for joining us for this celebration.
Y le damos a todos ellos el más fuerte de los aplausos. Please be seated.
Lectura de Proverbios 2:1-10. Hijo mío, si recibes mis palabras y aterrosas mis mandamientos dentro de ti, haciendo su oído a la sabiduría e inclinado su corazón a la prudencia, si llamas a la inteligencia y alta tu voz, si la buscas como la plata y la procuras como un tesoro, entonces entenderás el temor del Señor y hallarás el conocimiento de Dios. Porque el Señor de la sabiduría, de tu boca, conocimiento y la inteligencia. El proverbio de la sana sabiduría a los rectos. Es como un escudo a los que caminan rectamente. Guarda las senadas de la justicia y vuelva por el camino de sus santos. Entonces entenderías justicia, juicio y equidad. Y todo será un buen camino. Cuando la sabiduría entre en tu corazón y el conocimiento será grato a tu alma. La palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor.
This poem is collected of our finest memories at St. Annabert. We have been through a lot together, and we want to take a few minutes to remember some of our most important moments.
Este poema es una colección de nuestros mejores recuerdos en San Adalberto. Hemos pasado por muchas cosas juntos y queremos tomarnos unos minutos para recordar algunos momentos de nuestros momentos más importantes.
For all those that are reading, when you read, please remove your mask.
Nuestro
My first day at St. Albert, walking to the park as a school for field day, school dances with my friends, celebrating Mexican Independence Day, tie-dyeing shirts with my class.
Playing minute to win it games, Miller Park field trip in fifth grade, eating lunch in the cafeteria with all my friends, going to the pumpkin farm in K-4, and reading in my first mass.
Celebrating Catholic Schools Week, receiving the birthday blessing at mass, playing dodgeball with Mr. Ray, playing in the bounce houses, laughing and bonding together as a class.
Seeing each other virtually the first time, the first day of 8th grade, going bowling with friends, serving at mass, going to Discover World for a field trip, watching movies as a class.
Roller skating with the whole middle school, meeting new friends and teachers, receiving my first communion, singing happy birthday during lunch, and finally planning for a graduation and thinking of all the great memories I have at the school.
It is my pleasure to introduce our staff graduation speaker, Ms. Smith. Students had the chance to vote and nominated Ms. Smith to speak at our graduation. She is our math teacher as well as the grade level chair of the middle school teachers. Ms. Smith has been a teacher at St. Albert School for 3 years, starting the same year we all started middle school. We have learned so much from her and could not have made this year without her.
Welcome graduates, family, friends, teachers, and staff. We are all so excited to be here celebrating with you today. I am honored to be chosen to give the staff speech this year. Sitting next to you now are the people who have been there to love and support you through your time here at St. Albert. You have made them so proud. They were there when you got into your dream high school, they celebrated your trimester grades with you, and they encouraged you to try new things like a new club or a sport. This is a day they have been looking forward to since they dropped you off at your very first day at K-4. As much as this day is for you, it is also for them. Their babies are growing up. Give them a big hug and thank them. Thank them for being there when you made mistakes and giving you just enough tough love to succeed. I have been lucky enough to have been this class's math teacher since sixth grade. I even have had some of them in my homeroom twice. It has been incredible to watch them grow over the past 3 years. I have loved every minute of teaching this class. I will never forget their first day of sixth grade. They came into my classroom and sat there silently. They looked terrified. It took a couple weeks, but they soon came out of their shells. It is hard to believe that they were once nervous, quiet little sixth graders. Today, they are confident, bold, independent eighth graders, excited to start the next chapter in their lives, high school. My advice for you going into high school is to be yourself. You only get one chance at a first impression, make it a good one. Try new things. High school is the time for you to find out what your interests are. You are going to have so many opportunities, take advantage of them. Show your new teachers that you are kind, hardworking, respectful students with a great sense of humor. Make good friends, the kind you know will be standing by you at your high school graduation. And remember, you will never, ever be too cool to spend time with your family. They have been through it all with you. Make sure you take the time to appreciate them. Lastly, don't be in too big of a hurry to grow up. These are the best times in your life. Enjoy every minute. You have just made it through what is hopefully the toughest school year of your life. You are graduating after learning through a pandemic for a year and a half. If you can do that, you can do anything. You should be very proud of yourselves. I could not be more proud of the young adults you have grown to be. I admire that this class never takes life too seriously. You stand up for what is right, and you never give up when things get tough. Your future is bright. You are going to do so many big things in life, and I can't wait to hear all about them. You have made myself and all of us at St. Albert so proud. Congratulations, eighth graders.
Thank you, Ms. Smith.
Just as our talents and personalities vary, our feelings about moving on from St. Albert range in many different directions. The excitement and the nervousness, joy and sadness, anticipation and optimism, and doubt as well as anxious. All through, they can't say it all. We, the eighth grade class, would like to present two of our classmates, Romero Sanchez Saavedra and Emmanuel Ruiz Jimenez, to give some insight.
Hi. Please, Ramiro, move the microphone.
Hi, my name is Ramiro Sanchez Saavedra. I am 14 years old. I have been here at St. Adalbert since second grade, and these 7 years have taught me so many things. I have had so many fun experiences and made many memories in the classroom. There is so much I am thankful for, not only my classmates, but also the entire STAG community. When I first entered St. Adalbert, I was scared, but when I got to know everyone, I felt welcome during my first year here. I remember being excited to receive my first communion. The day of my first communion was one of the most exciting days at St. Adalbert. It was always fun when we went on field trips and had our lunch. I also remember loving to play dodgeball with my classmates and enjoying every game as we played as a class. I love when we ate all together because we made so many fun memories. I also really enjoyed Catholic Schools Week because we had a lot of awesome activities each day and a lot of fun. I will always remember the parties we had to celebrate Christmas, Valentine's Day, and all the other holidays. I would like to congratulate every single one of the eighth graders for making it this far. I wish I could congratulate each one of my classmates individually on what they accomplished. We all have strengths and differences. I know we all like different things, and being different is what makes us unique. We will do in this life what we were meant to do, and hopefully it is something we love and enjoy. The important thing is to enjoy life and always be happy. Teachers, I don't even know where to start. I will start by thanking every single one of you for letting me have so much fun these 7 years here at St. Adalbert. Thank you for having patience and trying your hardest to teach me and my classmates. I know we sometimes made it hard on you, but you always kept on trying your hardest to let us be the best we could. Thank you for giving us inspiration and showing us to keep on going even when we wanted to give up. I want to thank all of you for your hard work and dedication. I want to thank my classmates for many fun memories. My hopes for the future are to graduate from high school and get a career as a mechanical technician. I also hope that I can keep doing what I like best and what makes me happy. I want to make sure I have all my friends and family with me to support me in what I do. Most importantly, I wish happiness to everyone in this room. Lastly, I want to give a big thanks to two special people, Sheila Aragon and Joshua Diaz. Thank you for helping me through my tough times and being beside me through it all. I also want to thank my teachers and classmates, as well as my parents, for helping me to surpass my goals. Thank you all for having accompanied me during my years here at St. Adalbert. There aren't enough words for me to express my gratitude. I want to finish off by saying, to accomplish great things, we must not only act, but also dream. Not only plan, but also believe.
Un fuerte aplauso.
Good evening, I'm Emmanuel, and I've been in the school for 3 years full of memories. When I started out in sixth grade, which was the beginning of middle school and the start of a journey, I've made friends and met a lot of people, including teachers. Today is the start of a new journey, a new phase in life, the beginning of a new chapter for everyone as we progress in life. Today, we also remember all those memories in these years that remind us that we are not alone. Middle school was a long journey, full of surprises that were worth it. These 3 years of middle school were full of memories and fun. When we all started in sixth grade, it was like stepping into a new field with training wheels. Teachers helped us, but we all worked hard as a team to rise and start walking without those training wheels. Then, seventh grade was awaiting us to start running and rising to a new challenge. Throughout middle school, we obtained lots of memories and fun times together, from laughing in class, helping someone with work, or simple recess time that made the time valuable and worth it. Going on field trips with friends was an indescribable experience. Unfortunately, in seventh grade, a pandemic hit us unexpectedly. That didn't stop us from learning, and everyone at the school fought to learn one more day to have those memories with the people we see as family. We can still learn so much from these memories and use them to keep fighting and moving forward in the future. We have grown a lot by setting high goals. We also experienced lots of things and got through challenges as we still stand strong. In these years, we all changed. We all made new friends. We all saw each other grow, mature, and prepare to overcome any obstacle. There's a spark in everyone. It is amazing how far we have currently gone and what will we accomplish. As all these achievements and the future accomplishments wouldn't have happened without our parents if they had not sent us to the school and drove us back and forth every day. All this knowledge that we acquired wouldn't be possible without our teachers over the years. Thank you to the leaders of the church for giving us clubs and incentives, because these give us a chance to do what we like and possibly make a career out of it. I would like to shout out to the following teachers: Mr. Mears, Ms. Leitner, Ms. Powers, and mainly Ms. Smith for having lots of patience with everyone all these years. I also want to give another shout out to these students: Isidro, Isa, and Stephanie, and Saltio, because they were always there for me to make me laugh, and they were truly my best friends. We all took different paths this year and to set back plans for the future. We are not going to follow legacies or someone's footsteps. We are making our own legacy and footsteps to show that we walked on this earth. We didn't let our fears overcome us or stop us from being great. Although we haven't faced all of our fears yet, we have become so much better. We all learn how to live with fear and overcome it to make us stronger and brave. Middle school taught us how to be strong and have more confidence. Also know who we are and who we choose to be, and not let anything overcome us. We found ourselves, and now we are no one. Now no one will say otherwise, because we leave our footprints. Part of the journey is the end, and this middle school journey is coming to its end. As the new chapter starts, it is now time for us to define ourselves in the next 4 years that will be high school. The next chapter will be about finding ourselves once more, but in our definitive version, because we can still change. The opportunity to see each other grow and mature is a blessing, and we know there's still a lot of potential that we haven't reached. One thing's for sure, these memories and opportunities were a gift we need to hold on to, because these memories will allow us to keep going with all these bonds that we made. I want you to remember this quote: part of the journey is the end, but the journey is a long trip that can't be forgotten, because we traveled with friends and people that we see as family. Today we celebrate what awaits us in the future. The future, it's a mystery. The past is history with unforgettable memories. But today is a gift. That's why it's called the present. So let us know that we can do something beyond ourselves. Today we open a new chapter which begins in this new journey, a new rise. Thanks for your unique middle school journey and all these blessings along the way. I can't wait to see you all again and see the amazing things we've accomplished. Congratulations to the class of 2021. I wish you the best in your new chapter.
Un fuerte aplauso y felicidades.
Each of our middle school teachers will have a chance to recognize outstanding students from their classrooms this school year. The students were chosen by teachers based on academic improvement or academic achievements in each subject area. We will start our awards with our middle school science teacher, Mrs. Leitner.
The Science Award is given to students who exemplify scientific thinking. This is shown through an eagerness to learn, aptitude for problem solving, and experimenting. I am very proud to say that this year's Science Award goes to Emmanuel Ruiz Jimenez.
Fuerte aplauso.
Our next award will be presented by Ms. Botello.
My dear students, remember when you are called to receive the award and for the handing of the diplomas, you have the option to remove your mask for the pictures and share with the whole world your beautiful smile.
Good afternoon, I'm here to present the Religion Award. Religion is a vital part of St. Adalbert School. Being a Catholic school, we strive to keep our Catholic faith present in our students' lives as much as possible. This Religion Award is being presented to a student that not only actively participated in religion class every week, but consistently went above and beyond my expectations. They put forth their best effort in every single assignment, no matter how big or how small. Their love for God shone through every project and drove them to success. It is my honor to present this Religion Award to Joanna Guevara Olalde.
Un fuerte aplauso.
Our next award will be presented by Ms. Ramirez.
The Social Studies Award goes to Isaiah Hernandez. Isaiah is so dedicated to his work. This year, he's not only excelled academically, but was a positive role model during both in-person and virtual learning.
Bravo.
Our next award will be presented by our English language arts teacher, Mrs. Powers, and Ms. S.
Congratulations, 8th grade class. We are very proud of you and all that you have accomplished this year, especially in ELA. You have all grown in your writing capabilities, and when we had to choose a recipient for this award, it was difficult to just select one. We chose a student who has shown dedication, determination, and growth in ELA.
The student's always participating, trying their absolute best, and always looking for new ways to improve their reading and writing abilities. We are so happy to announce the winner of this ELA award together, and this award goes to Viviana Gonzalez-Cerna. Congratulations, and we're so proud of you. We will now hear from Ms. Smith as she gives out the math award.
This year, I am giving the math award to a student who has shown dedication and perseverance in math class. He is not afraid to ask questions when he needs to. He participates every day and gives every problem his best effort. He has grown so much in his math skills this year. Congratulations, Christopher Hernandez Lopez. Our next award, Overall Academic Achievement Award, will be presented by our Dean of Instruction, Mrs. Albert.
All right, good evening. I'm Mrs. Albert, Dean of Instruction, and I'm here today to award this year's Academic Achievement Award. This award goes to the student that has had the highest GPA in their time here at St. Adalbert. This student has also shown large amounts of growth on our school MAP test and came highly recommended by their teachers as a student that gives it their all every day. I am proud to announce this year's winner for overall academic achievement goes to Sofia Santillan.
Sí, señor. La mejor estudiante. Un fuerte aplauso, que se sienta.
Our final award will be the Eagle Spirit Award and will be announced by the Dean of Students, Ms. Manier. At St. Albert School, we have six values: community, justice, faith, dedication, and service, and joy. We encourage students to live out these values not only at school, but in their everyday lives. Our Eagle Spirit Award is given each year to a student who embodies our six school values. This winner is kind, considerate, compassionate to all of her classmates. She has been a valuable part of our community, and we wish her the best as she heads to high school. This year's winner of the Eagle Spirit Award is Ageda Solis Madrid.
Un aplauso para Ageda.
I would now like to introduce our principal, Mr. Heading, who would like to say a few words to our graduating class.
Good evening, graduates. I would like to welcome all of our families, friends, teachers, and staff, and anyone joining us virtually to this very special occasion. To have all of you here is truly a testament to the love and support that all of these extraordinary young people have in their lives. I would like to thank Ms. Manier, Ms. Smith, Ms. Ramirez, Mrs. Lozama, Mr. Newval, Emmanuel, Ageda, and others who worked very hard to provide a wonderful graduation evening for all of our students. I'd also like to thank Father Mauricio for celebrating with us tonight and for being the spiritual and community leader for our school. Buenas tardes, graduados.
Me gustaría dar la bienvenida a todas las familias, amigos, maestros y al personal aquí y los que nos acompañan virtualmente en esta ocasión especial. Tenerlos a todos aquí es verdaderamente un testimonio del amor y el apoyo que todos estos jóvenes extraordinarios tienen en sus vidas. Me gustaría agradecer a la señora Menier, señora Smith, señora Ramírez, señora Lezama, señor Noval, Emmanuel, Aguera y otros que trabajaron muy duro para brindar una maravillosa noche de graduación para estos estudiantes. También me gustaría agradecer al Padre Mauricio por celebrar con nosotros esta noche y por ser el líder espiritual y comunitario de nuestra escuela. To our graduates, this night is for you. These past couple years have been like no other. You've had to rise to challenges in a time of a global pandemic, to be students at home, and for some of you at school as well. For many of you, it has also presented the challenge of supporting not only your learning, but also helping in the learning of some of your younger siblings. You have risen above these challenges and have shown us and yourselves what you are truly capable of as young people. We are all very proud of you. The book of Isaiah says, "But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint." We at St. Albert are those eagles. We have watched you soar, and now we watch you move forward, knowing that your faith in God has given you strength, carrying you through your weariness, and it will allow you to journey through life without growing faint. Para nuestros graduados, esta noche es para ustedes. Estos dos últimos años han sido como ningún otro. En tiempos de una pandemia mundial, han tenido que enfrentar desafíos para ser estudiantes en casa y para algunos de ustedes también en la escuela. Para muchos de ustedes también presento el desafío de apoyar no solo su aprendizaje, sino también de ayudar en el aprendizaje de sus hermanos menores. Han superado estos retos y nos han demostrado a nosotros, a ustedes mismos, de lo que son verdaderamente capaces como jóvenes. Estamos orgullosos de ustedes. El libro de Isaías dice: "Pero los que esperan en el Señor renovarán sus fuerzas. Se remontarán con alas como las águilas. Correrán y no se cansarán. Caminarán y no se fatigarán." En San Alberto somos las águilas. Te hemos visto volar ahora, debemos avanzar sabiendo que tu fe en Dios te ha dado fuerza, te ha ayudado a superar tu cansancio y te permitirá caminar por la vida sin desmayarse. Many people will wish you luck to you as you move on from St. Albert to high school or from high school on to college. However, what most of us know is that little in life actually comes from luck. The best things in life come from faith, hard work, determination, and perseverance. So as you move forward today, instead of wishing you luck, I wish you faith, hard work, determination, and perseverance as you begin your journey to the rest of your lives. Mucha gente les desearía suerte mientras se van de San Alberto a la escuela superior o de la escuela superior a la universidad. Lo que la mayoría de nosotros sabemos, sin embargo, es que poco en la vida proviene de la suerte. Las mejores cosas de la vida provienen de la fe, el trabajo duro, la determinación y la perseverancia. Así que a medida que avanzan hoy, en lugar de desearles suerte hoy, les deseo fe, trabajo duro, determinación y perseverancia al comenzar su viaje hacia el resto de sus vidas. God bless all of you, and congratulations, class of 21. Dios los bendiga a todos, y felicitaciones a las clases de 2021.
Fuerte aplauso. Nos ponemos de pie. El Señor esté con ustedes. Proclamación del Santo Evangelio según San Mateo. Jesus said to his disciples, I tell you, unless your righteousness surpasses that of the scribes and Pharisees, you will not enter into the kingdom of heaven. You have heard that it was said to your ancestors, you shall not kill, and whoever kills will be liable to judgment. But I say to you, whoever is angry with his brother will be liable to judgment, and whoever says to his brother, Raca, will be answerable to the Sanhedrin. And whoever says, you fool, will be liable to the fiery Gehenna. Therefore, if you bring your gift to the altar, and they recall that your brother has anything against you, leave your gift there at the altar. Go first and be reconciled with your brother, and then come and offer your gifts. Settle with your opponent quickly while on the way to court with him. Otherwise, your opponent will hand you over to the judge, and the judge will hand you over to the guard, and you will be thrown into prison. Amen, I say to you, you will not be released until you have paid the last penny. En aquel tiempo Jesús dijo a sus discípulos, les aseguro que si su justicia no es mayor que la de los escribas y fariseos, ciertamente no entrarán en el reino de los cielos. ¿Han oído ustedes que se dijo a los antiguos, no matarás, y el que mate será llevado ante el tribunal? Pero yo les digo, todo el que se enoje con su hermano será llevado también ante el tribunal. El que insulte a su hermano será llevado ante el tribunal supremo, y el que lo desprecie será llevado al fuego del lugar del castigo. Por lo tanto, si cuando vas a poner tu ofrenda sobre el altar, te acuerdas allí mismo de que tu hermano tiene alguna queja contra ti, deja tu ofrenda junto al altar y ve primero a reconciliarte con tu hermano y vuelve luego a presentar tu ofrenda. Arréglate pronto con tu adversario mientras vas con él por el camino. No sea que te entregue el juez al policía y te metan a la cárcel. Te aseguro que no saldrás de allí hasta que hayas pagado el último centavo. Palabra del Señor. Please be seated. But as we sit, I'm going to ask all those who are graduating this evening, please stand up. All the graduates, stand up. Okay, good. Graduates, please stand up. Todos los que se están graduando, pónganse de pie. Muy bien. Leonardo, ¿estás contento? ¿Sí? ¿O tienes calor? Tienes calor. Me too. Okay. So now, I'm going to ask you something, because today we are here. And yes, this is the day where we come and we congratulate you. And indeed we are. And we are very proud for all of you. But I'm going to ask you something right now. Let us do something, okay? Just for a minute. Let us remove our mask right here. Just put it right here, okay? Good. Awesome. Now, let us share a wonderful smile like this. Great, awesome. We were expecting that. And now, I'm going to ask you, my dear graduates, te voy a pedir a ti que te estás graduando, que no te olvides en este momento de todas las personas que hasta aquí te han venido ayudando con oración, con apoyo, con amor, con cariño. I'm going to ask you, please, do not forget of all those that have been instructing you, praying for you, supporting you. And they are right here, right here, right here in church right now, around you. So I'm going to ask you that you may give a big hand to all those that are next to you, your parents, your friends, your teachers. Let's go. A big one in gratitude. Thank you. Thank you. And you can tell the ones that are next to you, thank you for your support. Thank you for helping me. Thank you for being here celebrating with me. Muy bien. Y ahora todos le damos a ellos un fuerte aplauso porque nos sentimos contentos, porque nos sentimos felices por ustedes. Muy contentos estamos. Now, please be seated. Today, as we just hear from the gospel, and there are two things that I'm going to remind you right now. Two things. There is a culture of life, okay? And this culture of life is getting built by the values that within this time we have been teaching you, okay? And these values are the values, the core values of our school. And those are dedication, joy, faith, service. And I'm missing some, Ms. Menier. So, dedication, joy, faith, service, justice, and community. Okay, good. So, there you have. And one of you just received that award because she was able to share, and I think that was Ageda, right? Ageda? Ageda, where are you? Okay, good. So, now, I'm going to invite you that as you receive the diploma tonight, you may say, well, finally, I'm done with St. Adalbert. Yes. You might be done with St. Adalbert, but you are not done with the world. The world is right there, just waiting for you. And this is the moment that we have to be awake, and that we have to go, and that we have to fight. To fight in order that we may build a culture of life upon a culture of death. Within this past year, we have been just learning from different scenarios about death. From war, there are many countries fighting to one another. There are others that want to threaten the dignity of the human person. There are others that are just trying to think how to kill a baby and promoting the abortion. Now, I'm going to invite you that as we go out, we have to go and we have to build a culture of life. That is the life of the Christian. And that thing is indeed built upon justice, dedication, faith, service, community. Above all things, that culture of life is built upon love. And that love that goes from one to another. Mis queridos papás aquí presentes, hoy nosotros celebramos con ustedes, celebramos este acontecimiento. Nos alegramos por sus hijos y con sus hijos. Nos alegramos porque hoy tú ves cómo los sueños de ellos siguen caminando y se siguen haciendo realidad. Aquí, San Adalberto siempre será una casa, siempre será una familia. Una familia que así como dice el lema de la escuela, Watch Us Soar, Aquí estamos nosotros y aquí vamos a estar siempre para verte volar, para verte crecer, para verte madurar. No te olvides de Dios. No te olvides de Dios. Ahorita, al salir de aquí, te toca ciertamente enfrentarte a un cambio. Hay un cambio por completo. Durante 8 años, a ver, ¿qué has pasado por todo este proceso? Has estado cuidadito. Llega el momento en el cual tú vas al high school y es un mundo totalmente distinto. Si en un momento te vistes en un proceso en el cual, en una mezcla de culturas, pues ahora vas a ver mucho más. Bien sea en Cristo Rey, en Thomas More, en Carmen, en Pius, todas esas escuelas te están esperando. Y nosotros que estamos felices y alegres, Marquette, a ver, allá vas, El Puente, St. Augustine, te están esperando. St. Lawrence Seminary, te están esperando. Pero no te olvides nunca de que tú has sido formado para construir una cultura de vida. Hoy necesitamos que esta vida se construya desde tu casa, desde lo que haces, en el amor al otro. No haciéndonos nosotros indiferentes con lo que está pasando el mundo. From now on, as you may exit from this church, remember that God is always waiting for you. But now on, you are going to go into a world that is going to become more challenging to find God. Because you will have options like here, like, for example, Lady Gaga on one side, okay? Probably Bill Gates on the other, and probably Jesus Christ will be somewhere else. Now this is the moment for you to grow. This is the moment for you to open your ear. This is the moment for you to celebrate life. So, my dear children, because you are always going to be called that way, our children. We are our children, and we are passionate about you, and as you learn, and as you grow. Here at St. Adalbert School, you will have always a home. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen.
Where should I move? Right here. Should I go that side? Should I move over there and just stay here?
Shayla Aragon Rios.
Congratulations.
Yesenia Barojas Barojas.
Congratulations. Look over there.
Yamileth Bazurto Estrada. Cynthia Campos Contreras. Jocelyn Celis Arenas. Malin Melissa Cruz Jimenez. Fatima Cuevas Tejeda. Crystal Diaz Delgado. Joshua Isaac Diaz Ortega. Salatiel Dominguez Macedo. Robert Anthony Escobar Trujillo. Axel Fuentes Verbunes. Stephanie Gayona Ibarra. Kaylee Crystal Garcia Velez. Isa Ruciel Gomez Barojas. Mariana Estefanie Gonzalez Olalde. Viviana Gonzalez Serna. Yamilet Gonzalez. Johanna Lizeth Guevara Olalde.
Continuemos aplaudiendo, celebramos todos. Felicidades, mira para allá.
Isaiah Yurem Hernandez Herdron. Christopher Hernandez Lopez. Lucio Angel Juarez Canada. Graciela Lara. Yadira Lopez Herrera. Guadalupe Madrigal Chavez. Leonardo Isai Martinez Ibarra. Hafid Nicholas Lira. Estrella Olalde Jalpa. Guillermo Ortiz Arevalo. Eric Adrián Padilla Cervantes. Andrea Perez Ruiz. Miranda Perez Santiago. Jocelyn Anahi Ramos. Alexandra Reyes Mata. Jariel Angel Rivera Coronado. Brian Roman Carretero. Betsy Nayeli Rueda. Emmanuel Luis Ruiz Jimenez. Fatima Sanabria Trejo. Ramiro Sanchez Saavedra. Sofia Catherine Santelan. Edgar Serna. Agueda Sofia Solis Madrid. Christian Terones Salas. Elizabeth Valdivia. Isidro Ruben Vega Miramontes. Santiago Villafuerte Zamora. Kimberly Zamora Martinez. Miguel Angel Zamora Paniagua.
Invito a todos los graduados a ponerse de pie. Mi querida comunidad aquí presente, es con gran alegría que presento ante ustedes a la clase de graduados del año 2021 de la Escuela San Adalberto. Y les damos un fuerte aplauso. Muchísimas, muchísimas felicidades.
While receiving their diplomas, students also received a flower. Eighth graders, please give your flower to your family. This is a thank you for all of your love and support. Please stand up if this is your last child at St. Adalbert School.
Al recibir su diploma, los estudiantes también recibieron una flor. Estudiantes de octavo grado, por favor denle su flor a su familia. Este es un agradecimiento por todo su amor y apoyo. Póngase de pie si este es su último hijo en la Escuela San Alberto.
Les damos un fuerte aplauso a todas esas familias.
At this time, we would also like to recognize the students and families who have been at St. Albert School since K-4. Thank you for your dedication and commitment to our school. Please stand up if you have been a family at St. Albert School since K-4.
En este tiempo también nos gustaría reconocer a los estudiantes y familias que han estado en la Escuela San Adalberto desde K-4. Gracias por su dedicación y compromiso con nuestra escuela. Póngase de pie si ha sido una de las familias parte de la Escuela San Adalberto desde K-4.
Ahí están las familias que han formado parte de nuestra comunidad, estos estudiantes desde K-4. Que se escuche ese aplauso, un aplauso de agradecimiento. Gracias por haber confiado en nosotros, en nuestra escuela. Muchísimas, muchísimas gracias. Al llegar la oración final, invito a todos a ponerse de pie.
Como la celebración llega a su fin, recordemos que todo es posible con Dios. Él nos fortalece y nos levanta, como dice Isaías 40:29-31. Él fortalece a los débiles y cansados, incluso aquellos que son jóvenes se debilitan. Los jóvenes pueden caer exhaustos, pero los que confían en la ayuda del Señor encontrarán su fuerza renovada, se levantarán alas como las águilas, correrán y no se cansan, caminarán y no se debilitan.
Amén. Y en estos momentos, así como estos graduados visten en tonos azules, encomendamos sus almas, encomendamos sus sueños y esperanzas y alegrías al cuidado maternal de la Virgen María, diciendo todos: Dios te salve María, llena eres de gracia, el Señor es contigo. Bendita tú eres entre todas las mujeres y bendito es el fruto de tu vientre, Jesús. Santa María, Madre de Dios, ruega por nosotros pecadores, ahora y en la hora de nuestra muerte. Amén. Nuestra Señora de Guadalupe, ruega por nosotros. San José, ruega por nosotros. San Adalberto, ruega por nosotros. El Señor esté con ustedes.
Y con tu espíritu.
Y la bendición de Dios Todopoderoso, Padre, Hijo y Espíritu Santo, descienda sobre ustedes y permanezca para siempre. Amén. Mis queridos hermanos, esta celebración ha concluido. Podemos nosotros irnos en paz, no sin antes darle el más fuerte y sonoro aplauso de felicitación a estos nuestros hijos. Muchísimas, muchísimas felicidades.